Bienvenue to the Marine Engineering Lectures. This is our third lectures on marine pump. Last lectures, I had already discussed about the how centrifugal pumps works and how liquid gets sucked into the eye of impeller and how impeller add kinetic energy to the liquid and how that kinetic energy of liquid is converted into pressure energy. In this lectures, we were going to discuss about one of the most important topic, which is always mostly and frequently asked by TME interviewers, university exams and MMD class 4 oral surveyors. So in this lecture we will going to discuss about one of the intellectual questions which is come in pump lectures, and our question is why centrifugal pump can't handle air or vapor. Why centrifugal pump can't handle air or vapor? So last lectures I had taught you about the how centrifugal pumps works, okay, and how that kinetic energy of fluid is changed into pressure energy of fluid. So let's prerequisite our last lectures which I had taught you. So first of all, this is what called reservoir, okay, atmospheric pressure is acting on the reservoir, okay, and this is what called sea water or just say liquid, okay, and this is what called suction line, suction line is incorporated with two components. First component is food valve, second component is strainer. What type of strainer? Quite type of strainer. So this is what called food valve and this is what called strainer. Food valve is just a kind of non-return valve, only one directional valve, okay, and this is what called Y type of strainer. I have already briefed you about the same. Okay, now this suction line is connected with the eye of impeller. This is what called eye of impeller, and this is called impeller. Okay, now that impeller consists of backward curved bends, okay, so this is what called. So in last lectures I have already briefed you about the significance of number of that curves or channel. This is what called channels. And this is what called backward curved bends. Okay, so this is here what called, it is called bore. Okay, now in last lectures I had discussed you about the various types of impeller, that is semi open type of impeller, open type of impeller, closed type of impeller. And this is what called semi open type of impeller. Semi open type of impeller means only one shroud is provided. But open type of impeller means no shroud is provided. In closed type of impeller means what? Both in front or in back side, both shroud is provided. Okay, so in this case, I am assuming here semi open type of impeller. Means one side is shroud and in front side there is open. So that's why it is called semi open type of impeller. Okay, and this is what called? This is what called? Bore, and that bore is connected with the shaft. Okay, this is what called shaft. Now that shaft is itself connected with one of the three components. It may be connected with electrical motor, it may be connected with steam turbine, it may be connected with diesel engine. I am assuming here that shaft is directly coupled with electrical motor. Now, as soon as we supply electrical energy to the electrical motor, so that electrical energy gets converted into mechanical energy. That is the only called definitions of electrical motor. Means that electrical motor is responsible for changing the electrical energy into mechanical energy, and that mechanical energy is utilized to drive the shaft. Now shaft is connected with the bore of impeller. Means what? That rotational energy of shaft is not transmitted to the impeller because it is connected with the bore of impeller. So first of all, that shaft is connected with electrical motor. Shaft is coupled with electrical motor. Input is electrical energy. Output is mechanical energy. And that mechanical energy is utilized to drive the shaft. And that shaft is connected with the bore of impeller. Means rotational energy of shaft is converted into the rotational energy of impeller. So as impeller rotates, as soon as impeller starts to rotate, at the eye of impeller, low pressure is created. With the help of low pressure, pressure difference is there. So because of pressure difference, this valve, food valve, opens and liquid gets sucked into the eye of impeller. First, liquid gets sucked at the eye of impeller or into the eye of impeller. So now, first of all, impeller is in a rotating position. Impeller rotates. Now liquid experiences some rotational force, and that force is what called centrifugal force. So with the help of centrifugal force, liquid get thrown from eye of impeller to the outward side, to the outer periphery of the impeller. Okay, liquid get thrown from the eye of impeller to the outward periphery of the impeller. Okay, and now further, that it goes to the process through the volute casing, and that is responsible for the conversion of that kinetic energy into potential energy, and it is reached to the required places, what we had discussed earlier. Okay, but now in this lecture we are going to discuss about why centrifugal pump can't handle air or vapor. So first of all, let me know one thing. Because of pressure difference, this valve is open and liquid get enter into the eye of impeller. So now, what force or which force is responsible for throw the liquid which is accumulated, which is enter into the eye of impeller to the periphery of impeller? Means there is some force now, that is outward force. And what is that force? That force is called centrifugal force. Means centrifugal force. Means what is the basic working principle of that centrifugal pump? The name itself centrifugal. Means the basic principle involved here, centrifugal force. And what is centrifugal force? That is m omega square r. This is what called centrifugal force. Because centrifugal force is only responsible for throwing the liquid from the eye of impeller to the outer periphery of impeller. No, with the help of only centrifugal force. No. So, and what is the centrifugal force? That is m omega square r. Okay, so what is the basic principle of centrifugal pump? Tell me one thing. What is basic principle of centrifugal pump? Basic principle behind it, what is centrifugal force? And what is centrifugal force? M omega square r. Now, first of all, what is m here? M is mass of fluid, whether it is liquid or means whether it is water or any other liquid. Okay, this is the mass of fluid. What is R? R is fixed because radius of impeller. Radius of impeller, which is fixed. What is omega? Angular velocity. Is directly related to the RPM of impeller. Note, most of the pump which is used in engine room or on board ship is fixed RPM type of pump. Their RPM is fixed. Such as in engine room, what kind of pump is there? First one is GS type of pump, is general service pump. Maybe it is seawater pump. Okay, general service pump, seawater pump, ballast pump, fire pump, emergency fire pump. So these whole pump are fixed RPM pump. Their RPM are fixed. Means angular velocity is fixed here. These all pump. Not all. In engine room there is one more pump called carbo-oil pump turbine, which working principle is centrifugal pump. Working principle is same as centrifugal pump. But carbo-oil COPT tank is not a constant fixed RPM pump. That COPT pump is variable RPM pump. That I will discuss later in COPT lectures. Okay, but these pump, that is such a general service pump or fire pump, emergency fire pump, seawater pump, these all are fixed RPM pump. Means that angular velocity is fixed. So in centrifugal force, that is centrifugal force, that is F is equal to M omega square R, means what? R is fixed, omega is fixed for most of the pumps, such as general service pump, seawater pump, ballast pump, fire pump, emergency pump. Omega is fixed. Now tell me one thing. Now that force means what force? This is called centrifugal force. Now tell me one thing. That force is directly depend on, that is mass of fluid. Because omega is constant and R is constant. Omega is constant for most of the pump, such as this whole pump which I listed below here. Okay, but now R is fixed, omega is fixed. Now that centrifugal force is directly depends on which factor, that is mass, mass of fluid. So now force that is centrifugal force is directly depends on the mass of fluid. Mass of fluid means either it is liquid or air. Means centrifugal force directly depends on the mass of air. Omega is constant and R is fixed. Okay, that is angular velocity is fixed here. Okay, this pump angular velocity, or we can just say the RPM of these pumps are fixed, say 1300 RPM. Okay, but now that centrifugal force directly depends on which factor? Mass, mass of fluid. Okay, now tell me one thing, which is heavier, or just tell me one thing, which is denser? Which is denser, air or water? Which is denser? Air or water? So if I talk about the sea level, at sea level, air is 784 times lesser denser than water. Means density of water is much higher than density of air. So if density of water is much higher than density of air at constant volume, means mass of water is higher than the mass of air. Means that is mass of water higher than the mass of air. Means what? Means in case of water, centrifugal force is more as compared to in case of air. Suppose I'm just assuming if air is getting sucked into the eye of impeller, suppose if air is getting sucked into the eye of impeller. Now impeller is in rotating condition. Now air is much lighter than water. Mass of air is less, no? So if mass of air is less, that is centrifugal force is directly depends on which factor, that is mass. So if mass of air is less and if air is getting and sucked into the eye of impeller, then what happened? Means because of less centrifugal force, air can't able to flow from the eye of impeller to the periphery of impeller because of lesser centrifugal force. Centrifugal force act on the air is much lesser. Now centrifugal force can't able to throw the air from the eye of impeller to the periphery of impeller or to the outer part of the impeller. Why? Because of lesser force. And why lesser force there? Because of lighter particle, because of lesser mass, because of lesser denser. So centrifugal force can't able to throw the air from the eye of impeller to the periphery of outer periphery of impeller because of lighter particles. And air get trapped at the eye of impeller. Air get trapped at the eye of impeller. And now in engine terminology, this phenomenon is only called air law. Air lock means losing of suction pressure equal to loss of suction pressure, which is denoted by PS. Because of air getting trapped here. Why air getting trapped? Because of lesser mass of air. Because that is force is directly depends on mass. And mass of air is lesser than the liquid. So because of less mass, less centrifugal force is acting on that, the means existing fluid, and in this case I am assuming existing fluid is air. So less centrifugal force is acting on air. So centrifugal force, that less centrifugal force is can't able to throw the air from the eye of impeller to the periphery, outer periphery of impeller. Okay, but in case of water, what happened? In case of liquid, now in second case, I am assuming liquid get enter into the eye of impeller. Now liquid is heavier or denser than what? Denser than air. Means there more centrifugal force is there. And now centrifugal force can able to throw the liquid from the eye of impeller to the periphery of impeller. And that is only the working principle of centrifugal pump. No. Okay, so that's why centrifugal pump can't handle air or vapor because of lesser, means lighter particles, because of their less denser. Air is much less denser than water. This is the only reason. Okay, and which cause air lock. And this is the most commonly terminology which is used by engineers on board ship, that is called air lock. What is air lock? Okay, and if air lock is there inside the pump, which means loss of suction pressure. And if suction pressure is loss, and if suction pressure get below the vapor pressure of fluid at that temperature, and it causes one term called cavitation. What is cavitation? How it occurs? What is net positive suction head? What is net positive suction head required and available? So all these things I will discuss in my upcoming lectures. So this is what the reason why centrifugal pump can't handle air or vapor. Okay, so this is our all about today's lectures. Okay, so if you have any doubt in this lectures, please comment it below. And further lecture means upcoming lectures, we will discuss about one interesting topic called cavitation. That is our next lectures. So this is our next lectures topic. So stay tuned, and please do like, share and subscribe to this video. And thank you for watching this video.